So as a graduate student here at the University of Toronto in the chemistry department, my research involves the synthesis, separation, and characterization of silicon nanocrystals for developing state-of-the-art applications like LEDs and biomedical imaging applications. And in a field such as nanochemistry, which is so interdisciplinary, I've had the opportunity to collaborate with researchers in fields from physics to biology, chemistry, engineering, both here at the University of Toronto and at institutions abroad.
The research that I undertake is extremely collaborative. So I start in the synthetic organic laboratory, make lead compounds that I think would be useful for something biological. And then, since the University of Toronto is such a collaborative and very interdisciplinary university, I take these molecules I make to the university hospital network. And this is the largest hospital network in Canada. And then I collaborate with clinical oncologists, biologists, people with skill sets that complement mine, and we investigate new types of biology using the chemistry that we develop in the Department of Chemistry at the university. Since the University of Toronto is so interdisciplinary and willing to collaborate, I can look at our department faculty list and walk down the street to talk to some other researcher that I think will complement what I'm doing. Almost everybody here is willing to collaborate. It doesn't even have to be within your own department. It's often interdepartmental and even with different faculties around the school.
So pursuing research in an interdisciplinary area has allowed me so many opportunities. I've got to meet researchers from a really broad variety of disciplines, and it's given me experience across such a broad area of science that I think it's really going to benefit me in my future career development.
Behind me is one of four state-of-the-art microscopes that we have in the lab that allows us to see chemical reactions happening at a surface and an atomic level. And on top of that, I use computational methods to be able to simulate what happens in between an initial state and a final state of a reaction. And we have one of the largest supercomputers in Canada, SciNet, that enables me to do this.
The research that I'm undertaking at the University of Toronto couldn't really be done at any other institution in Canada. My research requires the absolute latest technology in single-cell analysis, and this technology was actually developed at the University of Toronto in the Department of Chemistry. So it's something that I couldn't really accomplish at any other institution, possibly in North America at this point.
So I was very fortunate to be selected as a Vanier Scholar, and that's allowed me to focus all my attention on research. And I've also benefited from other scholarships from NSERC and the University of Toronto, as well as the chemistry department, and that includes some travel grants. So with that, I was able to attend conferences all over the world, and it's been a wonderful time.
So aside from doing research, I think one of the most integral parts about grad school is actually learning how to be a great teacher. And so the chemistry department at U of T provides you with so many opportunities to do that. So as a TA, there are several different positions you could have. The two main ones are either demonstrating a lab experiment or running a tutorial session. And so these are for undergraduate chemistry courses ranging from first to fourth year. And so as a TA, I think we really have an important role in these students' lives by influencing their enthusiasm as well as their attitudes towards chemistry courses. And we can even potentially affect their career choices as well. So I believe that TAing is one of the most rewarding experiences you can have at U of T. Aside from TAing, there's also different opportunities that you can have as well. So the department also offers fellowships to students who are interested in implementing a new tutorial style, lecture style, or even designing a new lab experiment. And so if you're interested in teaching or academia, the chemistry department at U of T provides you with so many resources to be able to improve your teaching goals.
My campus is on Scarborough campus. This is a beautiful campus surrounded by forests and a creek. And there are some professors on environmental chemistry and some other chemistry. The research there is very interdisciplinary. So there's experts in chemistry, biology, geography, and also in environmental sciences. So we have a lot of collaborations with professors on campus from other institutions. While Toronto is a very international city, there are international students on campus or off campus everywhere in the city. And I feel very welcomed at University of Toronto, also in the department, as well as in my group. I was living on campus in Grad House, which is a residence for grad students. And I had a great experience there. I had roommates from everywhere around the world. Like one of my roommates is from South Korea, some from India. So we had a really great time there.
So our chemistry department has a wonderful student association, Chem Club, that runs a small business and with the profits helps fund activities at all levels in the department, from undergraduate to graduate. And some of the activities include social parties and outings, networking events, as well as ski trips, recreational sports clubs, and lots of workshops and seminars. So that's a wonderful asset that we have here. This helps keeps us sane. I think the social activities adds a very nice dimension to the research aspect, which can get very intense and stressful. So it's wonderful to be able to interact with other people in the department.
So a few years ago, me and a couple colleagues were discussing, and we were looking for opportunities to learn more about green chemistry and ways that we can make our research here more sustainable. And one of the ways that we decided we would do that is forming a student organization called the Green Chemistry Initiative, which is based here in the Department of Chemistry. And we formed this group in order to teach ourselves about green chemistry, but also to share green chemistry with our peers and to help promote its use here in the department. So with really generous support from the department and the university, we've been able to form a full-fledged student organization and launch some really, really interesting initiatives, some of which include launching a monthly green chemistry seminar series. We host weekly trivia activities to promote and get people talking about things about green chemistry. We also hold an annual workshop, including this past year we had over 70 participants from countries from all across North America participate.
So Toronto is a city that is immersed in culture and diversity. So aside from all the skyscrapers in the downtown core of the city, Toronto consists of many different neighborhoods, each with its own unique personality as well as ambiance. There's different shops as well as different types of cuisine. And so just within walking distance of the department, we have Chinatown, Kensington Market, Little Italy, and much, much more. So in Toronto, you really can't get bored. You can attend a local sports game like the Raptors or the Jays or the Leafs, or you can attend a musical or show at Toronto's many theaters. And so this city really is a perfect place to achieve that ideal work-life balance.